Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about reflection versus absorption. Absorption is a term we use a lot of times, and we need to understand the tools that are available in this process. So let's first define our reflections. Reflections are energy that's greater than 100 cycles. Let's use that as our starting point and our definition for this discussion. And of course, all of us are working in rooms. So reflections are that energy that strikes the room surface, the room boundary surface, and comes back somewhere. Now, when it does that, it's striking a surface, so it's going to be altered doing that, and then it's going to come back and strike something else. A good example is the primary, secondary, and tertiary reflections we all have in our two-channel systems, because our primary is the boundary surface closest to the speaker. And then that reflection travels across from the, let's just say, right side wall to the left side wall. There's our secondary. And then the secondary travels back to its source. So we have this ping-pong effect of reflections going back and forth when we really want to hear just that straight, direct energy from our loudspeaker. So room acoustic design and analysis is all about balancing the reflected energy room sound with the direct energy from the speakers, which is more pure. So how do we do that? Well, the most common way today is absorption. Very cost effective, it's cheap. See a lot of building insulation, Roxul, DuPont. You have to be very careful with that stuff because it has its own rate and levels of absorption. And you must match the rate and level of absorption with the position in the room, the usage, all kinds of variables. There is no one size fits all. And I get this a lot every day with phone calls and emails. Well, I bought some of this, I bought some of that, and I put it here. And when I say, why did you do that? They thought that that was the thing to do because they'd read it, saw it in forums or things or places like that. So you have to be careful with these half-truths. You have to be careful with hyperbole, exaggeration, innuendo, all of these crazy things that we go through in the English language, the marketing people. You got to be really careful here, and you got to look at the science, look at what you're trying to do, and look at the process. Don't blindly accept what somebody says. Don't blindly accept what I say. Challenge what we say also here, and we'll get into a discussion about it. I've been building rooms for 40 years, so I think I have a pretty good handle on what works and what doesn't, but I'm always open for suggestions and new directions. So please don't hesitate to engage us in any form or fashion. What is absorption? It's molecular velocity. Remember in some of our videos, we talk about a cubic yard of air in your room, and it's full of little molecules. And when those molecules aren't moving and touching each other, we have silence. But when they start to move, when they start to bump into each other, then we have noise or sound. So it's molecular movement, and then what we do is we run that movement across the surface. Building insulation, foam, draperies, any fabrics, things like that that are absorptive in nature. And what does that do? Well, that changes, creates friction, which changes the energy to heat. And that's how we get absorption. It's an energy process change from one form to another. So friction and heat. Here's an interesting factoid. There is no temperature. People actually measure this. You can't. If you touch a drape or you touch a piece of foam and it's absorbing energy, you're not going to feel any heat. But there are some minute heat differences depending on amplitude and quantity of energy. So anything above 500 cycles, there's no increase in the temperature of this process. So a little bit interesting to work from. Here's another factoid that we've discovered. I think the literature will bear us out on this too. Air movement, the velocity from the surface is its best and greatest at 2 to 4 inches from the surface. That's why when companies that really know what they're talking about designing a sound absorption product, make sure that product is spaced out from the wall, because they know this rule. They know that 2 to 4 inches from the wall surface, the air movement's going to be the greatest. And then there's all kinds of reasons for that. We won't go into it in this video right now, but let's just accept that right now as a given. our foam technology actually has its own mounting system, which keeps it 2 inches from the wall. That way you're absorbing on both sides. What does that do? Cuts down the amount that you need. Saves you money. So keep that in mind when you're working with sound absorbing technology. What's another way to absorb sound? Resonating chambers, okay? Air movement across an opening or a cavity into a chamber. And remember, all these absorption processes are about air movement or velocity. Here, we're running air across foam or some limp mass material. Here, we're using a resonating cavity. And of course, the friction against the opening and the walls inside the cavity produce the absorption. So the cavity is designed for a resonant frequency. Everything above that resonant frequency is absorbed. Everything below is not. So you can design and tune these absorbers, in this case, the Helmholtz resonator, to this particular problem in the room. Hard to do. You have to be real good at it. It's not something that the hobbyist can really do because the calculations are extreme. So here's our two types we've discussed today, limp mass foam and the Helmholtz resonator. So two types of absorption processes that deal with reflection. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website and there's a book now button so you can book an appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.